हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव बीन लर्निंग चैप्टर नंबर 23 हाइट्स एंड डिस्टेंसेस। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टिल क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 ऑफ द टेक्स्ट बुक एक्सरसाइज। नाउ वी विल प्रोसीड फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 9। बट बिफोर आई अगेन रिमाइंड यू दैट डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल IGSE मैथमेटिक्स। प्लीज लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब फर्स्ट। ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच। Now let us start question number 9. Okay, in this question, the shadow of a vertical tower AB on the level ground is increased by 10 meter when the altitude of the sun changes from 45 to 30 degree as shown in the figure. In this case, figure is given. Find the height of the tower and give your answer to 1/10 of a meter. Okay, we are given a vertical tower in the question. Diagram is already given, so let me first draw the complete diagram. In the given figure, AB or BA is a vertical tower. Let us write down that AB is a vertical tower. Okay, AD is the shadow of the tower AB. Okay, CD is the increased length of the shadow. Clear? Values, angles are given. Angle ADB is given to be equal to 45 degree and angle ACB is given to be 30 degree. Okay, DC or CD is given 10 meter. Let AD is equal to X meter. Clear? And therefore AC will be X plus 10 meter. Therefore, AC will be equal to X plus 10 meter. Okay, now we want to find the height AB of a tower. So, let us take first triangle BAD. In triangle BAD, 1045 is equals to BA upon DA. Okay, we know that the value of 1045 is 1. BA we have to find out and DA is X. Therefore X is equals to BA or AB we get. Say this is result number 1. Now we will take triangle BAC. Okay, in triangle BAC 1030 is equal to BA upon CA. Value of 1030 is 1 upon root 3. So 1 upon root 3 is equals to BA is unknown and CA is X plus 10, and therefore BA or AB, let me keep here BA only, BA is equal to X plus 10 upon root 3. So this is result number 2. Now both the equation give us the value of BA or AB, so we can equate these values. Here BA is equal to X and here BA is equal to X plus 10 upon root 3. So we can equate these two values which are in terms of X from 1 and 2. I will remove this side now. Okay, now from 1 and 2 we can write X is equal to X plus 10 upon root 3. Therefore root 3X is equal to X plus 10. Therefore root 3X minus X is equal to 10. Ok, Okay, now we will take x common in the next step. Therefore, root 3 minus 1 into x is equal to 10. X is equal to 10 upon root 3 minus 1. Let us multiply by the conjugate of root 3 minus 1. So x upon 10, x is equal to 10 upon root 3 minus 1 multiplied by root 3 plus 1, root 3 plus 1. So 10 into root 3 plus 1, the denominator has formula a minus b, a plus b, that is a square minus b square. So root 3 square is 3 minus 1, 10 into value of root 3 is 1.732 plus 1 upon 2, and therefore x is equal to 5 into 2.732. Now let us multiply 5 by 2.732. So okay, 13.660. Therefore x is equal to 13.660 meter. Okay, now x is AB only, and therefore last few steps are left. We got the value of x. Now we have to round up this to 1/10 of 1/10 of meter. That is, we have to correct up to one decimal place. Okay, so let me complete this over here, and therefore x is equal to 13.7 meter correct to 1/10 of meter, and therefore x is AB only, 13.7 meter. In the first result we have proved that AB is x, BA or AB, and therefore we will write down a statement: height of tower is 13.7 meters. Please quickly note down this. Okay, now let us solve the next question. Question number 10. Okay, in question number 10, it is given that angles of elevation of the top of a tower from the two points on the ground. We are given a tower, say AB is a tower and C and D be two points on the level ground. Okay, angles of elevation as seen from C and D respectively are complements of each other. It means, if suppose angle C is alpha, then angle D will be its complement, that is given by 90 minus alpha. Is it clear? Further, the distances of these points are given from the tower. The distance BC is a meter and the distance BD is B meter. Let us write down this fact. Okay, here AB is the tower, C and D are two points on the ground. Angle ACB we have taken to be alpha, and therefore एंगल ए डी बी विल बी 90 माइनस अल्फा सिंस एंगल ए सी बी एंड एंगल ए डी बी आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री दे हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन क्लियर ओके फर्दर डिस्टेंस बी सी इज गिवन टू बी ए मीटर्स एंड डिस्टेंस बी डी इज गिवन टू बी बी मीटर्स हियर वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट द हाइट ए बी वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट द हाइट ए बी इज इक्वल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ ए बी मीटर्स लेट अस प्रूव लेट अस फर्स्ट टेक द ट्राइंगल ए बी सी इन ट्राइंगल ए बी सी tan alpha is equals to AB upon BC therefore tan alpha is equal to AB we have to find out BC is A and therefore A into tan alpha is equal to AB say this is our result number 1 okay now we'll take triangle ABD so In triangle ABD, tan 90 minus alpha will be equal to AB upon BD. Clear? Because the angle is 90 minus alpha. Okay, now we know that tan 90 minus alpha will be equal to cot alpha. So in the next step, we will put here cot alpha, and BD's value is B, and therefore. Cot alpha is equals to AB upon B and therefore B cot alpha is equal to AB. Okay, this is result number 2. Okay, now look at the two results. RHS is equal on both the sides. So LHS can be equated. If RHS is equal then LHS is also equal. So we will equate. Sorry, in this case what we will do, since we have to find out the value of AB, we will multiply the two equations. So multiplying equation 1 and 2, this step we will write over here. Okay, so now multiplying equation 1 and 2. So A tan alpha into B cot alpha is equal to AB into AB or changing the sides AB into AB will be AB square is equal to here small into small b into tan alpha into cot alpha. Now we know that tan alpha and cot alpha are complements of each other, therefore their product will be 1 and therefore AB square is equal to AB into 1 and therefore AB square is equal to small AB and therefore AB will be equal to therefore AB is equal to square root of AB, so we got what we had to prove, and therefore we will write down that the height of the tower is square root of AB meters. Please note down. Okay, now let us solve question number 11. Okay. In the next question, you are given a lighthouse. Say, AB is the lighthouse. A man is rowing away from the lighthouse. A man is sitting in a boat and he is rowing away from the lighthouse. Okay, let us consider the two positions of the boat at two different times. Okay, height of lighthouse is given to be 150 meters. The angles of elevation as seen from the position C and then as seen from the position D are different. They are given to be 60 and 45. So when the boat is at point C, the angle of elevation of the top of the lighthouse is 60, and when the boat occupies position D, it is 45 degree. Okay, you are given to cover the time distance DC. So a boat takes 1.5 minutes to cover distance DC. It is given in the question. Okay, let us write down the description. Here AB is the lighthouse. Okay, C and D be two positions of a boat at two different times. AB is given 150 meters, angle ACB is given 60 degree, angle ADB is given 45 degree. Okay, and time taken to cover distance DC. Time taken to cover distance DC is given to be 1.5 minutes. We have to find the speed of the boat. It's very clear that if you want to find the speed, we can apply a formula to calculate the speed, distance upon time. Now the time taken to cover distance DC is given 1.5. So if you can calculate the distance DC, then distance upon time will give us the speed. That is our required answer. Okay, so our target, first target is to find out distance DC. How will you find out distance DC? So for that, first we will calculate distance BC by taking triangle ABC with the help of trigonometric ratios, and then we will take triangle ABD and we will calculate distance BD. Then BD minus BC will give us DC. So let us proceed in this manner. First we will take triangle ABC. So in triangle ABC, tan 60 is equals to AB upon BC. The value of tan 60 is root 3, AB is 150, BC we have to calculate, and therefore BC is equals to 150 upon root 3. Further, let us simplify further. We will multiply by the RF, rationalizing factor of root 3, both numerators and denominators, and therefore BC is equals to 150 upon root 3 multiplied by root 3 into root 3. Therefore BC is equals to 150 root 3 upon 3. 350 is R, and therefore BC will give us BC is equal to 50 root 3. So this is result number 1. I hope this step is clear. Now let us take another triangle, triangle ABD, to calculate distance BD. In triangle ABD, tan 45 is equals to AB upon BD. Okay, value of tan 45 is 1, is equal to AB is 150 meters, and BD we have to calculate. and therefore BD is also 150 meters. So we got the value of BD. Now let us calculate the value of DC by subtracting BC from BD. So we'll do this on the right side. Okay, now DC is equal to BD minus BC. Therefore, DC is equal to 150 minus 50 root 3. Okay, well, value of root 3 is known to us, that is 1.732. Okay, we will get the answer, it is 6.6. So 150 minus 86.6. Okay, that will give us something. Sixty-three point four. We will get. So this is the distance DC. Now we have to find out the speed. So let us put the formula to calculate speed. Now speed is given by distance upon time. Okay, so distance covered is 63.4 upon time is 1.5 into 60 meter per second. Time was given in minutes. We have converted that into seconds by multiplying with 60. So this will be 90, which is approximately equal to 0.7 meter per second. Please note down. I hope you have understood well this question number 11. This is an important question. Okay, now let us solve the next question, question number 12. Okay, what is question number 12? Let us read out the question. Two pillars of equal height stand on either side of a roadway which is 120 meters wide. At a point on the road lying between the pillars, the elevations of the pillars are 60 degree and 30 degree respectively. Find the height of each pillar and the position of the point. Let me explain you this question. On both the sides of a road, two pillars of equal height are standing. Okay, so let us draw the two pillars standing on the either sides of a road. Say AB and CD are two pillars of equal height. Let us consider that E is a point on the road such that the angles of elevation of the two towers of equal length are given to be 60 degree and 30 degree. Clear? Okay, the width of the road is given to be 120 meter. Let us write down this description. Okay, here let AB and CD be two towers such that AB is equal to CD is equal to H. meters we have taken, because in the question it is given that the heights are equal, so both height of both we have taken to be h. Okay, you are given angle AEB is given to be 60 degree and angle CED is given to be 30 degree. Width of the road is BD, that is 120 meters. Let us consider that the length BE is X. Let BE is equal to X meters, and therefore ED will be equal to 120 minus X meters. Okay, this length is 120 minus X. Again, one by one we will take the two triangles. First let us take ABE. Okay, so in triangle ABE, tan 60 is equal to AB upon BE. Value of tan 60 is root 3. AB is H, BE is X, and therefore H is equal to root 3x. Say this is result number 1. Okay, now take triangle CDE. So in triangle CDE, tan 30 is equal to CD upon ED. Value of tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. CD is H, ED is 120 minus X. Therefore 120 minus X upon root 3 is equal to H. See, this is result number 2. So we have got the two values of H. Let us equate both. So from 1 and 2, I hope the steps explained so far are clear. Okay, now from results 1 and 2 we can write that root 3x is equal to 120 minus x upon root 3. Okay, now let us simplify. Therefore 3x is equal to 120 minus x. Therefore 4x is equal to 120, and therefore x is equal to 30. We got the value of x. Now we can put the value of x in equation number 1 to get the height of the tower. So let me do this on the right hand side. Substituting value of x in equation 1. Okay, what is equation 1? H is equal to root 3 into x. This is equation 1. Therefore h is equal to root 3 is 1.732 into x is 30. We will multiply. Okay, so 51.960, therefore h is equal to 51.960 meters. This is the height of the tower. Therefore we will write down a statement that height of tower meters, and the position of the point on the road is 30 meters from tower AB. Okay, so and the position of point E, is 30 meters from pillar A. Please note down. Okay, let us solve the next question. Question number 12. Okay, let me read the question. Okay, question number 12 we have already solved. Question number 13 we are going to solve now. Okay, angle of elevation of the top of a vertical tower PQ from a point X on the ground is 60 degree and at a point Y 40 meter vertically above X, the angle of elevation is 45 degree. Find the heights of the tower PQ and the distance XQ. Okay, you are given a tower PQ such that Q is the top. So let me draw a tower PQ. Okay, we have a point on the ground, say X. Now, angle of elevation as seen from X is given to be 60 degree. Now we have one more point vertically above X. Say this point is Y. So when seen from Y, the angle of elevation is 45 degree. Clear? This vertical height is 40 meters. Okay, and two angles of elevation are given. We have one wire perpendicular to PQ. That is right on the description. Let PQ is equal to this vertical tower. Tower Q is the top of the tower. X is a point on the ground and Y is a point which is 40 meters vertically above X. Yeah, we are drawing YR perpendicular to PQ. Now angles of elevation are given. PXQ, angle PXQ is 60 degree and angle RYQ is 45 degree. We have to find out the height of the tower and we also have to find its diagonal length XQ. Two things we have to find out. One by we will find out. Look at figure XPRY. Obviously it is a rectangle and we know that opposite sides of rectangle are equal. So if this is 40 and then this is going to be 40. So here let us mention that XPRY is a rectangle and therefore PR is equal to XY is equal to 40 and XP is equal to YR. XP is equal to YR. Here, now we will consider that height QR is X. Let QR is equal to X meter, therefore PQ will be X plus 40 and therefore PQ is X plus 40 meters. Now we will take figure triangle XPQ. Okay, so in triangle XPQ, tan 60 is equal to XP upon PQ upon XP. Tan 60 is root 3 is equal to PQ is X plus 40 upon XP is XP only and therefore make x be the subject, so we have x plus 40 upon root 3. So this is result number 1. Clear? So first we have taken triangle XPQ, taking 10, 60, PQ upon XP, then putting the values. When you simplify, make XP the subject, you will get XP is equal to x plus 40 upon root 3. Now we will take the smaller triangle, triangle QRY. Now in triangle QRY, 10, 45 is equal to QR upon RY. 10, 45 is 1, QR is X, and for RY we can substitute XP. Okay, from since we have proved this, XP is equal to YR, we have earlier shown in rectangle opposite sides are equal. Now here we will make XP the subject, so we will get XP is equal to X. Okay, so now the further steps I'm going to write on the left hand side. I will remove this. Therefore XP is equal to X. So this is result number 2. Now we have two values of XP in the two equations. If LHS is equal, then RHS is also equal. So from 1 and 2, we can write down X is equal to X plus 40 upon root 3, and therefore root 3x is equal to x plus 40. Therefore, root 3x minus x is equal to 40. Taking x common, we have root 3 minus 1 to x into x is equal to 40. Therefore, x is equal to 40 upon root 3 minus 1. Let us multiply the both numerator and denominator by the conjugate of root 3 minus 1, that is root 3 plus 1. Multiplying both numerator and denominator, so we will simplify to get x is equal to 40 into 1.732 plus 1, and the denominator will be a square minus b square, that is 2. So 220 is a, so 20 into 2.732, and therefore x is equal to we will get 54.64. okay, this is the value of x, 54.64. I hope all the steps are clear till here. Okay, let us give this number 3. Okay, now we have to find the vertical height PQ. So PQ is given by PR plus RQ. So 40 plus value of x is 54.64. Clear? So let us finish this. Okay, now PQ is equal to PR plus RQ is equal to 40 plus 54.64 is equal to 94.64 meters. This is the height of the tower. Okay, therefore, okay, last, I will write on the statement at last. First, let us find out XQ. Okay, now XQ, this is hypotenuse. Clear? In order to find XQ, hypotenuse, if you need to find, you can take either sine or cos. So which one to take? See, PQ and XP, both the values we are having. So you can take either of sine or cos. I am taking here cos. Okay, we have value of XP, that is X. Yes or no? That is 54.64. We have already got. So XP in triangle XPQ, we will take cos 60. Clear? Now in triangle XPQ, cos 60 is equals to XP upon X cube. Okay, cos 60 is 1/2, XP is 54.64 upon X cube. So finally you will get X cube if you multiply 54.64 by 2, and therefore X cube is equals to 2 into 54.64. X cube is equals to 109.28. Okay, so this is the value of X cube. Finally, we will write down the statement that the height of the vertical tower is 94.64 meter and the distance X cube is 109.28 meters. Therefore, the height of tower is 94.64 meter and the distance XQ is 109.28 meters. Please note down. Okay, now next question. Question number 14. Okay, let me read out the question. A man 1.8 meter tall stands at a distance of 3.6 meter from a lamp post and casts a shadow of 5.4 meter on the ground. Find the height of the lamp post. Okay, so let us draw the diagram for this and let me explain you this question. In the question, there is a lamp post. A man, shadow of a man is there, okay, and we have to find the height of the lamp post. So let us draw first a lamp post. Suppose AB is a lamp post and CD is a man. And say that AD is the shadow of the man. Clear? Lamp post height we have to find out. This is our answer required. Man's height is given 1.8 meter and the length of the shadow is given to be 5.4 meter. Let me write down this description first. Here AB is the lamp post, CD is a man, and ED is a set of men. Okay, CD is given to be 1.8 meter, ED is given to be 5.4 meter. Okay, distance DB we will take to be X. Let DB is equal to X. If required, we will see. However, it will be required only. Okay, in the diagram we will draw CF perpendicular to AB, and this angle's value we will take to be theta. Okay, draw CF perpendicular to AB and let angle AEB is equal to CED, same only theta. Okay, now we will begin with the smaller triangle CDE. Clear? Because we have theta, we have perpendicular and base. So using 10 ratio, you can find out the value of 10 theta. So in triangle CDE, 10 theta is equal to CD upon ED. Therefore, 10 theta is equal to 1.8 upon 5.4. Therefore, 10 theta is equal to 1 upon 3. See, this is result number 1. Yeah? So, 10 theta we got. Further look at this. These two angles represent a pair of corresponding angles, and therefore these two angles are equal. Clear? Because if you consider line passing through CF and EB, okay, to be two parallel lines, and AC is transversal, then these two angles will be corresponding angles. So we will write down this explanation now over here, that angle ACF is equal to angle AEB is equal to theta, since these are corresponding angles. And further, if CD is 1.8, then FB will be 1.8. further, FB is equal to CD is equal to 1.8 meters, since opposite sides of a rectangle are equal, and therefore FB, CF, FC, sorry, FB only. So this FB is 1.8 meter, and similarly CF and DB, CF is equal to DB is equal to X, for the same reason. Okay, this reason will apply here also, same reason. So now this is X. Okay, and we have to find out the height AF. So let us take triangle AFC now. Clear? What we will take? Triangle AFC. Okay, so let me write down this over here. Okay, now in triangle AFC, 10 theta. Okay, 10 theta is equal to AF upon CF. I think one value is given in the question, 3.6 meter. Okay, this distance already is given 3.6. No need to take this distance to be X. Okay, so this is 3.6. Make it 3.6 over here. In the question it is already mentioned. Clear? So now 10 theta, okay, so CF and DB 3.6. Now let us substitute the values. So tan theta is equal to AF upon CF. Value of tan theta is 1 upon 3 is equal to AF. We have to calculate, and CF is 3.6. So now it is very easy to calculate AF. AF will be 1.2, we will write down over there. Okay, after we have got AF, we can add AF and FB to get AB, clear? Okay, therefore AF is equal to 3.6 upon 3. Therefore AF is 1.2 meters. Okay, now we have to calculate AB. So AB is equal to AF plus FB. Therefore AB is equal to 1.2 plus 1.8, and therefore AB is equal to 3 meters, and therefore height of the lamppost is 3 meters. And therefore height of lamp post is 3 meters. I hope you have understood. Let me once again explain this question. In the question, AB is a lamp post, CD is man, ED is the shadow of the man, and the DB is a distance between the lamp post and the man. Clear? Initially, you are given three values. Height of man, that is 1.8 meter, length of the shadow, that is 5.4 meter, and this distance of a man from the lamppost. Okay, we started with triangle CDE, okay, and calculated tan theta, because perpendicular and base both the values are given, so you can calculate the value of tan theta. After taking that tan theta, and knowing the fact that the rectangular has opposite side equal, so DB is 3.6, so CF will also be 3.6. Okay, and CD is 1.8, FB will be 1.8. So this CF value we got to be 3.6. Again, we explained that these two angles are equal because they are corresponding angles. So in the smaller triangle AFC, I have taken tan theta again. So AF upon CF, so putting the values, you will get the value of AF. After you got AF, you can add AF to FB in order to find out the height of the lamppost, which is 3 meters. Clear? Now let us solve the next question, that is question number 15. Okay, question number 15. Let me read the question. In the given figure, a man stands on the ground at a point A, which is on the same horizontal plane as B. The foot of the vertical pole BC, at the height of the pole is given 10 meter. The man's size is 2 meter above the ground. He observed that the angle of elevation is C. He observes that the angle of elevation of C, that is the top of the pole, yes or no, and the top of the pole as x degree, and value of tan x degree is given to be 2/5. Let me first draw this figure and explain you. Okay, here BC is a pole. A man is standing, you can consider his height because it is given already 2 meters. This is 2 meters. Angle of elevation, if you look at the two points as observed from D, okay. So this is the eyes man. So if the man looks at the top of the building or the tower or pole, it is x degrees, and a value of 10x is also given to be 2/5. Okay, height of the pole is given 10 meter. Height of pole is given, this height is given 10 meter. We will draw A, B, C, D, DE perpendicular to BC. 10x is 2/5. We have to calculate distance AB in meters. Okay, we have to calculate this distance of the man from the tower. Let us write down the description first. Let BC, okay, BC is a pole, vertical pole. Okay, AD is a man. Length AD is given 2 meter. Okay, BC is given 10 meter. Angle CDE is given to be x degrees, and you are given the value of 10x in the question. 10x is 2/5. We have to find out distance AB. Okay. Let us once again understand this figure. In the figure, BC is a vertical pole. AD is a man. Okay. D we will consider as the height of a man, or it is the eye of a man. Okay, now from point D, if you look at the top of the pole, the angle of elevation is x degrees. Clear? And the value of 10x is given to be 2/5. Man's height is given to be 2 meter. Pole's height is also given. So we can use this value, fact given. Okay, but before that, what we will do? AB, ED is a rectangle, therefore AD and BE will be equal, therefore BE will be 2 meter. So we will calculate CE. So 10 minus 2 will be 8. Okay, so let us write down that explanation first. Okay, now AB, ED is a rectangle, and therefore BE is equal to AD is equal to 2 meter. And therefore CE is equal to BC minus BE, and therefore CE is equal to 10 minus 2, and therefore CE is equal to 8 meter. Okay, now we can use 10 ratio in triangle DEC or CED. In triangle CED, 10x is equal to CE upon DE. Okay, 10x is given to be 2/5, CE is 8, DE we have to calculate, therefore DE is equal to 8 into 5/2, and therefore DE is 5×20 meters. So we calculated the length DE, and DE and AB are equal, so that is our final answer. And therefore AB is equal to 20 meter, since AB and DE are equal, being opposite sides of a rectangle. And finally we will write down the statement. Therefore the length of AB, or the distance AB, is 20 meters. Please note down. I hope you have understood all the questions I explained so far. Today we started from question number 9 and ended till question number 15. Further questions we will solve in the next video. Thank you very much.